My dear friends and family, I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala you're all doing well, inshallah. Today I'm recording this message as a reminder for myself and for all of you about the importance of these first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. There aren't any days greater, nor any days in which deeds are more in them, beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Most High, than these 10 days. So increase in them saying of Tahleel, La ilaha illallah, and Takbir, Allahu Akbar, and Tahmeed, Alhamdulillah. These days are like the last 10 days of Ramadan. They're no less in importance than the last 10 days of Ramadan. Remember how you were in the last 10 days? From fasting, to praying all night, to feeding all those who are fasting? There are no good deeds more loved to Allah. So which kind of good deeds? Any deeds, all kinds of good deeds. So are you prepared? Do you have the niyyah or the intention? Have you encouraged those around you? Fasting, supplication, making dhikr, helping others, giving, keeping relationships, friendships. No days in which good deeds are more loved to Allah than these days. I wonder, are you fasting? Are you picking up the phone and asking about your family? Are you getting up in the middle of the night to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Do you remember the amount of enthusiasm we had in Ramadan? Do you want to finish reading the Quran in these 10 days? And how lovely it would be to do your khatma on the day of Arafah. Arafah is the most day in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives, and the most day in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saves from hellfire, more than Laylatul Qadr. And even Laylatul Qadr, we don't know which night it is exactly. We stay up all night supplicating, oh Allah, save us from hellfire tonight, and we aren't even sure if that's the night or is it any of the other nine. But with Arafah, we are certain, we are sure, we know for a fact that on that day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saves people from hellfire. تُعْتَقَ الرِّقَابِ. Do you understand the magnitude of this? Do you understand what we're approaching? And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears in the Quran, He swears by something very important. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرِ. By the dawn time and by the 10 nights. These are the 10 nights that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing by. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by something, how important is this something that He's swearing by? How valuable is it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When Abdullah ibn Umar would walk in the markets in the first 10 days of the Hijjah, he would walk around doing takbir, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. And the people would ask him, and looking astonished, why are you doing takbir? Eid isn't yet here. He would reply, these are the dearest days to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in which He loves dhikr and takbir and dua, and asking for forgiveness. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the best of dua or supplication is the supplication on the day of Arafah. Materialism has overtaken our lives to an unbelievable extent, and we have strayed away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I beg you to fill these 10 days with worshiping, prayer, fasting, dhikr and supplication. We don't have 30 days left like in Ramadan. It's only a few nights left to make benefit of. Raise your hands to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala and tell Him, please, Allah, these are the 10 dearest days to You. Please aid me to worship You as You would like. And know that for every little deed that you do, you become more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Can you imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's beloved? What more can you ask for? Have our hearts rusted to this extent? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's love is being offered to us. And every good deed you do, and despite that, you still turn away from doing good. Fast and read Quran and give charity and pick up that phone and call your relatives and your family that you haven't asked about for years. There aren't any days in which good deeds are more loved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than these 10 days. There's only a couple of days left, and this sale for good deeds will be over, and the days become regular days again. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أَلَا إِنَّ لِرَبِّكُمْ فِي أَيَّامِ دَهْرِكُمْ لَنَفَحَاتِ أَلَا فَتَعَرَّدُوا لَهَا. Truly for your Lord in some of His days are whiffs that you're exposed to, so expose yourself to it. If you find a chance like this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you all these deeds and all this forgiveness, grab it and take this chance. It's a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And don't miss out on fasting on the day of Arafah. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, he was asked about fasting on the day of Arafah, and he said, it expiates the sins of the previous year and the coming year. Can you imagine all your sins from the entire past year and the ones that you're about yet to do in the coming year to be forgiven? With piety and observing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's all erased, it's gone. Can you imagine? What generosity is this? Spread the word and tell your friends and your family and motivate them. These are great days. Don't waste them. We don't know if we'll live till next year to get this chance again or not. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow you and your families with His mercy in these blessed days. May He gather our hearts upon what pleases Him. May He use us to spread His word and never exchange us with others. May He warm our hearts to doing good and grant us His love. May He be pleased with us and accept us among His righteous, Ya Rabb. May He forgive our weaknesses. Ya Allah, we beg You to destine us to be from the among the ones that You forgive in these 10 blessed nights from Dhul Hijjah, from those who You will ask and tell them, "Are You pleased? I am pleased with You." And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your fasting and your good deeds in these 10 days. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you all have a very blessed and happy Eid, inshallah. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.